Lava. Lava is the magma that flows from the volcano. It descends like a great river, burning everything it finds along the way. Igneous. An igneous rock is formed when the lava that leaves the volcano solidifies. Ash and gas. Sometimes the gas coming out of a volcano is dangerous and poisonous. Crater. The crater is a large hole at the top of a volcano. The magma rises from the crater and flows out of it as lava. Fumaroles. Fumaroles are a mixture of gases and vapors that rise through the external cracks of a volcano at high temperatures. Inactive volcano. Volcanoes that have not been erupting for a long time are called inactive volcanoes. When they have been inactive for a long time, they are extinct volcanoes. Cone of the volcano. Inside the cone of a volcano is the chimney. When a volcanic eruption occurs, the magma rises to the surface, passing through the chimney. Magma. Magma is the hot and molten rock found inside the earth, accumulated in the magma chamber. Sometimes, if there's a lot of pressure, the magma finds an outlet to the outside. It's a volcano that erupts. Tsunami. When an earthquake occurs at sea, the vibrations cause waves. These waves grow and grow until they are huge and break on the coast. Sometimes these waves can also cause great damage. Richter scale. Not all earthquakes cause the same damage. To know the level of severity, a scale is used. It's the Richter scale and has 10 levels. From level 6 onwards, it's a serious earthquake. Epicenter. The epicenter is the point on the surface of the earth closest to the inner point where the earthquake originates. It is usually the place where the most serious damage occurs. Seismometer. The seismometer is a machine that records the seismic waves that cause earthquakes. colliding plates. The rocks that form the Earth's surface also move. They can move sideways or up and down. The line separating the tectonic plates is called a fault line. When the plates move, they cause vibrations that propagate on the Earth's surface and make everything tremble. It's an earthquake. Wastewater. Wastewater from sewage, from factories and cities, is taken to the treatment plant, where it's cleaned and returned to the rivers. Wind energy. This energy is generated by using the power of the wind. The wind has been used for many years to move the blades of the mills and is currently also used to move wind turbines. Wind turbines are mills that put turbines in motion and are connected to a generator that produces electricity. Solar panels. Solar panels are the solution that has been found so far in order to capture some of the energy from the sun and convert it into electricity. We can find solar panels in large thermal power plants, on many house roofs, or in small samples, for example, to the ones used only for powering a laptop. Non-renewable energy. Only 18% of the energy produced in the world is renewable. The rest is obtained from non-renewable sources, such as coal, oil, wood, or nuclear energy. These energies, which are also called fossil fuels, are limited and cause more pollution. Energy transport. The electric poles and cables that can be seen along the road in the cities and in the fields in the countryside serve to transport energy to wherever it's needed. Geothermal energy. Geothermal energy is that energy that can be obtained by taking advantage of the heat inside the earth. It can be used to obtain hot water or to produce electricity. Solar energy. Energy from the sun reaches the earth, being the source of life and the source of most other forms of energy on our planet. But it has taken many years to know how we could harness energy from the sun and turn it into electricity. Wind energy. This energy is generated by using the power of the wind. The wind has been used for many years to move the blades of the mills and is currently also used to move wind turbines. Wind turbines are mills that put turbines in motion and are connected to a generator that produces electricity. Plants. Plants are living things that grow everywhere, even in the rivers and seas, deserts, and on the icy summits of the tallest mountains. There are some small plants and giant plants. In order to survive, a plant needs earth, water, and light. The sun. It's a star at the center of the solar system and constitutes the greatest source of light and heat of this planetary system. The Earth and the other planets of the solar system and other celestial bodies orbit around the sun. The equator. The equator is an imaginary line that crosses the Earth and is equidistant from the two poles. In areas nearest to the equator, the length of day and night is relatively constant during the year. Layers of the Earth. In the interior of the Earth, there are different layers. The first layer is very thin and is called the Earth's crust. The Earth's crust is a solid layer. Next, there comes a layer of incandescent rocks that is in continuous motion. In the center of the planet Earth, there is a large core composed of metals. Global warming and the greenhouse effect. Greenhouses, where some plants are sometimes grown, allow the sunlight inside and retain the heat. The atmosphere that surrounds the Earth works similarly. The atmosphere lets the sunlight through and retains the heat, thus keeping the planet at the right temperature. But nowadays, there are more and more gases in the atmosphere that increases the greenhouse effect, and the Earth is getting too hot. The poles. The poles are the fixed points around which the Earth rotates on itself. The Earth takes 24 hours to turn around itself. The North Pole and the South Pole are the coldest areas on the planet Earth. The Moon. The Moon is the only natural satellite on Earth. The moon takes 27.3 days to go around the Earth. It's the only celestial body that men have walked on so far. Earth. Earth is the planet in the solar system where we live. Earth is home to millions of species, including humans, and until now, the only planet where life is known to exist.